Hello and welcome to Woodland Sticks for another video. We're going to do antler carving today. I've had several people asking me if I could do a video on it. So this will just show you the basic starts on having a go at a bit of antler. So this will be your first sort of lesson, really. We can't do too fancier stuff, but to get yourself started, most of you can get hold of these type of drills, either battery or mains, and they just run on a flex, and you just get an on and off switch up the top. Or you've got the other motors like these, which are more powerful. They've got a bigger head to them, so you've got those, and they'll run on a foot control, so it's you can get your speeds up and down on your foot control. But today these make quite a bit of noise. I'll just show you one to start with. That's the sort of noises you get. Sorry, I'll say it again. That's the sort of noises you get with the Dremel or the big motors, the big flexi shaft motors. So what I'm going to use is more of a dental type of thing. It'll take different size burrs and bits, and there's a few burrs on the bench. I don't know whether my cameraman can actually get in and get a good picture. You don't need many different burrs, but you just need a few assorted types. So if you can hunt around dentists and that type of thing, they'll often give you them, or have a look on eBay, you can often find them. If you get the steel ones like those, or you can get the diamonds. The diamond ones are a lot cheaper, but don't do a lot of good. They're more for your finishing off work rather than starting. So what I was going to do for you today was, we'll do a woodcock. So there's a picture on the bench of a woodcock. So what I've done is, using a photocopier, shrink it down to a small enough size that will fit the coronet on your antler. So we're gonna actually use that as a model or something to copy onto the top of our antler. So that's how it's going to be onto there. So what I need to do now is take off, this is where the antler has actually been shed, that's fell off the deer, and that is where it was attached to the skull. It's very, very rough. So what I want to do is to take some of that away, get that smooth, and then we've got a better surface then to work on. So I'll have a go with this one. I'll put a coarse burr onto it. Let's get it working. Right, so I'll put a coarse burr into it. If I can, that's better. Right, so I've got a coarse burr into it now. So now I just want to take off this crusty bit on the top. So just turn it on. Get about half a speed to start with. I haven't got any dust extraction working at the moment because, again, it's too noisy. So if I had that sort of thing running, you wouldn't hear what I'm saying. So all I'm doing really, using a nice coarse burr and just getting rid of the bit that's on the top. So I'm not worried about getting it nice and smooth or anything, just getting rid of that rough stuff. Right, so that's that off. Now, turn that down. Right, so now we'll smooth that off. Now, what I like to do now is, I want another burr in there, and I'll go for that type of thing. It's just a little cutting burr, and what I'm actually going to do is use that as a rotor bit. So I'll get me picture of whatever I'm going to carve. You need to reduce it down from your picture so it's going to fit nicely onto your coronet for your carving. Now, I'm a bit used to mine, so you might want to glue yours on. It doesn't matter, because I've always got the picture to go on. So if I cut a piece or whatever, I've always got the main picture as a reference. So now what I want to do is to go right round this. I've got it where I want it. I want to go right round this and use this like a router. So I'm going to a bit more. I'm just drawing a rough line round. I'd rather have it bigger than I need it. So just going round it. I've got quite a long old beak on here. I've already bent the beak, but it doesn't matter. I just want a rough idea as to where it is. Then I can take the picture away. Coming down the wing. I have to keep turning it, so I hope you can actually see what we're doing. Turn it around, go under the wing. Quite an unpleasant smell, this, the burning of the bone. Reminds you a lot of when you're sat in the old dentist chair and having a filling done. We're nearly round it now. As I say, we can't do every little detail, but right, so we've got a rough idea now of our woodcock. So that's the outline of it done. Now I want to do a bit more in depth. So I'm going to take another burr, which has got a sharp corner edge on it. So I'm going to use that edge to, I'm going to say, I've got the reference page there, so I can still keep an eye on everything. Right, so I'm coming round with a tile. Now it's really cutting in. And then hopefully we can come round by the beak in a minute. So dust extraction would have been the best bet, but there you are, we haven't got it. Well, we have, but right, so we've been round that part. Now we come round the bottom. Right, so there we're getting it. So I now want to change burrs again. So I'm going back to the rough one because I want to move stuff in a bit of a hurry now. So I'll take that round back on again. Now all this stuff on the outside of this is your rough, that's your white. So we don't need any of that. Should start to get back down to our carving again. So, that round here. See, these bigger birds are worth buying. You only need one or two. It just saves you a lot of time when you're working. Go as deep as you'd like with it. Right, get rid of some of the dust. Now you can see the bird is sort of starting to take a bit of shape. So again, we go back to the original burr, the one shaped like a dovetail, and we pop him back in again. So now we want to dig in and get ourselves nice and clean. So we've got a nice straight edge all the way around our carving. Start. So you can actually see the bird has all taken shape now. I'll put a few pencil lines on and we'll come back and finish that in a minute. Let the drill carver get cool. It's warmed up quite a bit. Right, so I'll just do some pencil lines and then we'll come back to it. Right, so I'll put a few pencil lines into it. I'm no drawer at all. I cannot draw. So there's our template, and that's what we've copied on there so far. So I'll put the template back on. Get him as nice as you can. And we've got more or less everything covered. We've cut everything away. Now the idea is finishing off. So the edges need rounding off. We're going to have to determine where the wings come in and that type of thing. Just putting little marks in. The head needs smartening up. So that's the bit I'm going to do now. So I'll put power on again. So I've got the big picture still as a reference, so I can start using that. Right, so I need to put that back on again. I need to just double check something. Yes, right. So I need to take a bit more away from here. There then, his beak is obviously going to be lower than this piece. So I just want to take some of his beak away. And I can't do it so I stick him out. So it has to actually be locked down low on your carbon. And so it's so thin, the beak. The head needs a bit of a rounding off. The neck needs a bit of rounding. Now the body comes round like that. So start to round this part off now, the part of the wing, and that'll come right across to here, like that. So I'm going to dig down here a bit to bring a wing across. Now, the wing is coming across to that. This part of the other wing, and that comes down a bit lower. So I'm pushing the wing down, and that will come round this way. It's going to have a wing running through here. So again, I'm just putting the mark in. Then, looking at the picture, I don't know whether you can see the whole lot, but the wing finishes off here. So onto the carbon. And just get rid of the dust to come into here to get rid of some of that for the wing. Don't forget that the thing is a lot bigger than what we're actually doing. So have that there. Tail needs a little bit of a round on it. It's just a matter of keep looking at your picture and trying to get the same on your picture. So the wing comes round here again. So you can see how everything is working out. Now I need to take some of this wing away, so, and some of that wing away. So I'll go on to my bigger burr again. It saves a lot of messing about with the little one. And so these don't take too long to do, really. Right, back on again. So I want to take quite a bit of this part of the wing away. And it's obviously going to be quite straight, so, or flat, I should say. Now we come right down into there. We got rid of that. This is the outer wing on the other side. So you can see how I'm leaving it up to the body. And then the tail. So now we're getting it like that, we need to start to round some of it off. So we'll start to round off the outside wing like that. There's a little line running there. Now here's the body. We'll take that away. There's the body. Now the other wing comes in like that. So we'll have a little bit of a dent there. I'll take some of that away. That comes right across to here. And obviously the body carries on through. Right through to the tail. Right, so now we can see it starting to come on now. So we've got most of the rough off it. It's now a matter of finishing up, putting all the wings in, or putting the little wings in, and different bits and pieces. So let's see what bear we go on to now. We'll go on to that one. I'm going to use, what, I've got six burrs lay here, so you don't need a lot of burrs to do this sort of thing. Right. So I like to keep everywhere clean at the same time. So keep your background clear, and put a little eye socket in there. I'm making use of that hump there to actually give me a body on the bird. Starting to take shape nicely. Just put a bit of detail into it in a minute. How the wing would come in. So, just a feather I use, just the corner of the drill, and just put a little row of feathers in, like that. Well, I could be, you know, work on these and do as much as you like, really. Just change me bit again. Now what I'm looking for now is to go cut underneath it a little bit. So I'm using a tiny head on my burr, and I want to go under the wing. Put the wing in. Then I want to cut under it. Just gives it a bit of detail. If you can just undercut the wings a little bit, or the wing, that gives it that much more detail. And then they go over onto this wing, and we'll try and take a little bit out of that. It just gives it that impression that it's there. Right, so now we want to tidy up and cut a little bit underneath. That'll really help to make that stand out. Right, so we've got that. And we've got our line through there for the rear of the body. Have a look at the plan. Yeah, so follow this straight line through here. Okay, basically all I do for feathering is just little marks. The tail has sort of got longer ones on, going like that. A bit more on the wing. Alright, so we've got bars go across the top of the head. Seems it's a woodcock. We need to tape around that beak. So we're making the beak stand out a bit. Take a bit from underneath that part of the wing. Head sort of thing, head bars going across it, so just put some little bits across like that. Should take care of that. Could even try to put a bit of beak in. So I'll change over now to a diamond burr. These have got a rough coating of diamond on the sides of it. This one's right a sharp point, so I can get in and do a lot of undercutting and detail and work with this. So I can get in right into here. And I think undercutting, just putting a line round underneath the carving, helps to stand it out a little bit. Like that. So if you go all the way round your carving and just undercut that nicely, that helps to bring that out. taken a little bit away. It's not doing a lot of work. These diamond burrs are a lot cheaper than the seal burrs. You get some nice shapes in it. You see how you can go right under your wings, under your bird and everything. So you just put a little line in and you're done. Right, so I'll just put a little eye in there, I think. That's basically all that'll need is a hole. Helps to bring it all to life a bit. So I'll just do a bit more feathering on the body. It needs all tidying up all round here, but I mean that's easy enough to do. I'm sure you can manage that once you get used to your tools. I will just do a little bit to show you what I do. I use this little bit here, and it's flat on the bottom. So I use that for cleaning up, mostly around my carvings. So I'll just put that on. That's all these little marks that you put in as you're carving, you see. So. Just a matter of tidying them all up. Like that, it's there, sort of starting to look nice. So you can do go all round it. I mean, you could do whatever you wanted underneath it, really. You know, if you want to do some sort of pattern, put dots in or whatever else, you could quite easily do that. So say, I'll just put a bit more detail into the bird. I'll just rough it up a little bit with a corner. And I say, you can take bits away while you're doing this if you're not happy with where they are. It's just a matter of putting a little bit of detail into it, really. Bit like using a rubber on the end of a pencil, really, isn't it? Rubbing off the bits you don't want. So sorry, I hope that sort of helped you a bit, give you a little bit of idea as to how to do a carving in antler. Say the see how long the film has took as to. That's not a very long process once you get an idea of it. I mean, still got a lot of tidying up work to do all around the outside and all that type of thing. So it's basically there. So it gives you a good idea now as to how to have a go at it. And so long as you shrink down your picture, use it as a stencil, and have your main picture there, where you can keep looking at for a little bit of reference. And so just enjoy your carving. You're bound to get a lot better than that. While you're here, I will show you a few I have done to give you some sort of encouragement. Well, cock pheasant there, he's done out of the coronet bit as well, and I'll put a little whistle on the end of it. But I mean, they're all the sort of things you can do once you get into another one there, an old grizzly bear. It's just playing with different bits. Another little bit I had on the top of that one, I done a little fox on it. I've still got to finish him off. I've got his eyes and that more to sort out, but that's the sort of thing you can do. These bits are just out of a coronet, but obviously a little bit more detailed, the rabbits. I find Antler is a lovely medium to work with. There's another one. That's quite a simple carving, really. Just a brace of pheasants hanging on a little hook. It's all just play. It's have a go at it and enjoy what you're doing. And we'll catch you soon.